JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for June the 23rd. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar continued sliding against most of the other major currencies. The only currencies against which, the only currencies which did not, against which the dollar did not underperform were the Japanese yen and the Swiss franc. It eked out some gains against the Japanese yen, while it was found virtually unchanged against the franc. The greenback lost the most ground versus the Canadian dollar, the Kiwi, and the Aussie. Once again, the weakening of the US dollar and the Japanese yen, combined with the strengthening of the risk-linked loonie, Kiwi, and Aussie, suggests that markets continue trading in a risk-on fashion. Indeed, looking at the performance in the equity world, we see that most major EU indices closed in the green, with a positive appetite rolling into the US session. Where Nasdaq hit a fresh record high. Investors' morale stayed upbeat during the Asian session today as well. European shares traded slightly higher ahead of Fed Chair Powell's testimony, as investors may have continued to increase their risk exposure based on comments by ECB President Lagarde, who said on Monday that she and her colleagues will maintain an accommodative stance, as well as following remarks by New York Fed President John Williams, who said that data and conditions have not progressed enough for the FOMC to shift its monetary policy stance. Investors continued to increase their risk exposure during the US session as well, especially after Fed Chair Powell said, "We will not raise interest rates preemptively because we fear the possible onset of inflation," putting at rest concerns that interest rates could start rising as early as next year. New York's Williams spoke again yesterday, adding that a discussion about raising interest rates is still way off in the future. Investors have already allowed equities to correct lower following the hawkish outcome of the Fed meeting last week, and thus, now with every evidence pointing that interest rates are not likely to start rising anytime soon, they seem excited to add to their risk exposure. However, this could have diminishing effects as slowly participants are likely to start digesting the idea of rate hikes not coming soon, which could result in negative surprises if Fed officials start slowly shifting in the hawkish direction again. For now, we prefer to hold a cautious stance despite some indices hitting fresh records, and wait for more officials to make their views and opinions public. In that respect, today we will get to hear from Boston Fed President Eric Rosengreck and Atlanta Fed President Rafael Bostic. As for today's events, today we get the preliminary PMIs for June from the Eurozone, the UK and the US. With regards to the Euro area, the manufacturing index is expected to have declined slightly to 62.2 from 63.1, but the services one is anticipated to have risen to 57.5 from 55.2. This is likely to take the composite index up to 58.8 from 57.1, confirming that the bloc continues to recover from the pandemic-related economic damages at a decent pace. However, we don't expect the euro to gain much on potentially strong numbers, as the ECB has made it clear that they are not thinking about scaling back their monetary policy support anytime soon. No forecast is available for the UK prints, while in the US, both the manufacturing and services indices are expected to have declined somewhat, but to have stayed at elevated levels. As for the rest of the releases, we have Canada's retail sales for April, which are expected to have declined around 5% month over month in both headline and core terms, as well as the US new home sales for May, which are anticipated to have increased somewhat. With regards to the energy market, the Energy Information Administration report on crude oil inventories for last week is coming out, and the forecast points to a 3.942 million barrels decline, following a 7.355 million barrels for the week before. However, bearing in mind that yesterday the American Petroleum Institute report revealed a 7.199 million barrels inventory decrease, we would consider the risk surrounding the Energy Information Administration forecast as tilted to downside, something that may help oil prices trade higher. As for the speakers, besides Boston Fed President Eric Rosengreck and Atlanta Fed President Raphael Bostic, we will get to hear once again from ECB President Christine Lagarde. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye. Have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.